First showed you he took down his house and threatened to keep the bank from seizing his business by bulldozing that too.
Yeah, it didn't look good, but tonight, hope for a happy ending for that owner and the bank.
Curtis Fuller broke this story. He's live tonight with a follow-up, our number one pick. Curtis?
Well, time is definitely running out for the Claremont County man who, as you said, took unusual steps to dramatize his battle with a bank. But final hour negotiations with creditors and support from folks who apparently feel his pain might turn this whole thing around for Terry Hoskins.
On any other Sunday, this Amelia carpet store would be closed. But today, the doors were open for business.
But my board's completely filled up.
And those are all?
Yeah, customers that came in to support me, yeah. It's getting close to that day, so.
That day comes this week when the bank puts Terry Hoskins' 27 acres of commercial property on the auction block. Hoskins bulldozed his home earlier this month because of an ongoing dispute with his bank and the IRS. Many have wondered, will he do the same thing to his business?
It doesn't look like it. Yeah. I'm going to wind up going to the sheriff's cell.
Hoskins received this notice. This is what he needs to save his property, more than $500,000.
I got stuck with a number of $666,066.67. So I got all sixes.
Terry Hoskins has gotten help from friends trying to come up with money he'll need. They've been selling hats, T-shirts, even virtual bricks on a website.
You said tomorrow is a big day.
Yeah, just to see where everything's going to fall into place.
But Make a break day?
I believe I'll be making it.
Now, it's likely he'll only have to come up with 10% of that money for the business property at the sheriff's sale. Believe it or not, he also might be close to a deal to hold on to his property where his house once stood. Jack?